I'll just kick it off with a kind of a view of, from an investing perspective, if you believe any of this, last year, about $500 million was invested by VCs in around 75 projects. What's directly attributable, maybe another $200 million directly by banks. We saw the consortium, which you've already heard from today, form. We saw a movement into open source where, you know, sort of a movement to draw people into that. We saw a lot of large technology companies. You've got an inflow of capital from VCs. You've got major end customers involving. You've got open source movement. You've got strategic technologies moving in. And you've got a consortium in the industry. So clearly, the momentum's there. And I don't know what multiple you put on the reported numbers, whether it's 3 or 5, but you know the actual investment is a huge multiple of it. So all we can say at this point is the movement's underway. Shift now a little bit and go just to the what lessons we learned from technology. There is a theorem in technology that says it takes about 5 to 7 years to develop a core technology. And after that, once you hit an inflection point, about 18 to 24 months to till it develops to the point of no return. So the theorem you have here is blockchain as a fundamental technology. It's been around. It will hit an inflection point. There's plenty of proof points of other technology, so opening foray to whoever would like to take it. What do you see as the parallels to the adoption of these technologies?
The internet 25 years ago faced a fork in the road, and that fork was an ad-supported model versus a pay-as-you-go or payment for microtransactions model. The interchange couldn't handle those, and trust was a factor in terms of how you would pay, so we went down a very deliberate road. Point being, you had digital currencies then. You had a number of upstarts that happened between then and now, but it's only been in the last 3 or 4 years that you've had enough of a deployment and enough interest, first on the digital currency side, which I think of as a use case phenomenon, and then obviously with the underlying core technology behind it, with blockchains and their usability.
So I think it's very dangerous to compare anything to the internet. It's a one-off historical phenomenon. I think a close analogy, if we're fond of analogy here, is voice over IP. So voice over IP was a partnership between technology companies and large incumbents to digitize a medium, in that case voice, so that it could transfer more seamlessly across border at lower cost, so that we could build new products and services we couldn't build before. And likewise with blockchain technology, we're seeing money over IP. Or assets over IP. Again, for similar themes, we want to have a lower cost model, we want a more flexible digital infrastructure that we can innovate on. And I think the big question for folks in the room as you think about analogies, and a big theme for us at Chain when we talk with our partners, is to recognize that not everyone gets to win. This is not a technology where you streamline your back office the way you would with a faster email server. This is a technology that was pointed out in the prior panel where people will go away over time. And so the question is, whether it's a game theory question or just one of strategic kind of positioning, where do you start and which alliances do you build and how do you get to market so that you're positioned to win? And so that for us is a closer analogy with respect to existing asset classes than the internet might be.